Hey guys, we know how much you loved our camping foods video because you guys watched it a lot. So we're bringing you not one, not two, but four more recipes that are complicated, tried and true, but just all around delicious. So check it out.
We love a good breakfast meal, especially one that you can eat any time of day. Sometimes when you're camping, you might go out hiking or biking or spending the day adventuring, and you need something really, really filling and calorie dense. Shepherd's breakfast is a great option. I personally call this a heart attack in a pan, but it is super delicious. Shepherd's breakfast consists of bacon, onion, potato, eggs, and cheese. To cook this meal, you start by adding your bacon and onion into a pan and cooking it down until it's nice and crispy. Then throw in your potato. Now, your potato doesn't have to be a certain way. We've tried this with leftover French fries. We've tried this with just regular potato. You can also try it with grated potato. Really, potato anyway is going to work. Once your potatoes are cooked, top it with all of your eggs, add some cheese on top, and put either tin foil or a cover on top of your pan until the eggs and cheese are cooked and melted. This is definitely a camping meal that does not disappoint. My plating skills were not on par on this one, but this is basically bacon, French fries, or hash, depending on what you want to make it with, topped with eggs, topped with cheese. So, I mean, you can't go wrong. A quick tip if you're making shepherd's breakfast with regular potato wedges or slices. I like to pre-cook my potato before I start to cook the full shepherd's breakfast. This is because if you try and cook them completely raw during the shepherd's breakfast cooking process, your bacon and onion is going to be way overcooked while you wait for the potato to actually cook. So if you pre-cook them a little bit, take them out of the pan, and then throw them back in when your bacon and onion is ready, it's going to make things a little bit easier. If you're looking for an easy but delicious meal, steak and corn on the cob over the campfire is a must. This meal might look complicated, but it's actually one of the easiest things to cook because you literally just throw it over the campfire, let it cook, take it off, and enjoy. A couple of quick tips before you start cooking your steak and corn. We always pre-soak our corn with the husks on in water. This is going to keep the corn nice and moist as we put it over the really hot heat. We also take our steaks out of our cooler about half an hour before we're going to cook them to let them get down to temperature. This is going to make sure that they cook more evenly when we put them in the cast iron skillet. Once you're ready to cook, season your steaks, put some oil in your cast iron pan, and let the oil get steaming hot. Once it's hot, throw your steaks on there and throw the corn over the fire. The length of time you cook your steaks for is going to depend on two things: how big your fire is and how you like your steaks cooked. We had quite a large fire and we like our steaks pretty rare, so we only did a 2-minute flip on each side. For the corn, don't be afraid if the husks start to look burnt. Your corn on the inside is still cooking nicely and will be absolutely delicious. Once your steaks are cooked, take them off the heat and let your meat rest before cutting into it. This also gives you a little bit more time to finish cooking off your corn on the cob. You can also cook this entire meal over campfire coals if you don't want to do it over an open fire. Next up, we have a recipe that's great as both a meal and a snack. Quesadillas. These can be as complicated or as simple as you want them to be. We like to keep our quesadillas as simple as possible, so we literally just put cheese and green onion in a tortilla and toast it up. We love to make these as snacks in between our meals or the morning that we are leaving camping so that we can have something to eat on our drive home. To make the quesadilla, throw your tortilla in the pan and toast it up a little bit on both sides. Put your cheese and other fillings on half of the tortilla and close it up. From there, you just let the one side toast, flip it over and let the other side toast, and just make sure that your cheese is melted in the middle. The last recipe we want to share is something a little more complicated. It's a Greek beef stew, and it's cooked in our Mengrills pot. We love using our Mengrills for anything stew or soup related while we're camping. It fits perfectly over the campfire and can be used as a regular pot or as a pressure cooker. Now, because this recipe is more complicated, we have a whole separate video for it. So if you want step-by-step instructions on how to cook it, head on over and watch the Greek beef stew video. All in all, this recipe uses beef, orzo pasta, tomato paste, whole canned tomatoes, a little bit of red wine, and salt and pepper to taste. Once it's all cooked, you top it with feta and enjoy. We also love this recipe while camping because it's a one-pot meal. Although it has more ingredients than some of our typical food, it is really easy to make because you literally just throw everything into the pot and let it cook. If you're looking for even more camping meal ideas, check out our first two camping meal videos. Each of them contain 5 recipes each. Simply head over to our YouTube channel, click on the videos tab, and in the search bar type camping meals. You'll see both videos come up in the search results. And stay tuned. With all of our upcoming camping trips, we've got lots more recipes planned that we can't wait to share with you. Well, that wraps up this video of another 4 easy camping meals. We hope you enjoyed these recipes and they hit the spot while you're camping. If you like our content and you want to support us even further, please consider sharing our videos, heading over to Patreon to become a patron, or checking out our merch. Thanks for watching. Tia and Andy out.